on the corner of Dave Niehaus Way and Edgar Martinez Drive. Welcome to T-Mobile Park. Major League Baseball on tap. It's the Minnesota Twins taking on the Seattle Mariners. First pitch coming your way next. Just about set to go down. And on the hill in this one, Bryce Miller. How about a scouting report on him?
A power pitcher that is going to pitch aggressively with the fastball. His fastball velocity ranks near the top in the league. Also throw the slider, but if you're a hitter, be ready for the fastball. You're going to see a few of them during your at bat.
Ready to go. And now for the Twins, Willy Castro. That misses the zone, and that's ball two. Swing and a miss as he was out front. 2-2. The 2-2. Ground ball right side. Takes it himself. One out in the top of the first. And now we take a peek at the Twins lineup. We could be in for a power showcase today with the wind blowing out a lot of lift and separate, Chris.
Well, we know hitters are in this era definitely trying to hit the ball in the air regardless of the conditions, but I think even a little more so there's margin for error if you can get the ball up in the air. So, you know, you'll see at times, I'm sure, with two strikes, what looks like a half swing that can get out of the ballpark with a hitter who's got decent pop.
The wind of the pitch. Fouls it back with two strikes. One down, base is empty. Here's Royce Lewis. And a pitch. On the ground. Moore tosses to first.
He's out.
And the Twins go 1-2-3. We're midway in inning number one. No score. Back at T-Mobile Park and towing the slab, Pablo Lopez.
This guy has a ton of respect from his own teammates, Boo. He's the type of guy, if he's not having a good day, he'll go out there and just wear it. No matter what happens, his starts tend to be less demanding on the bullpen.
We go to the bottom of the first. J.P. Crawford gets a chance to hit.
Not shortstop. J.P. Crawford.
And Pablo Lopez will deliver.
Cold night like tonight, last thing you want to do as a hitter is get jammed or even off the end. Trying to find that sweet spot on the bat. Tell you what, you're going to be trying to catch things out front, so off-speed pitches may be a good complement to that fastball.
Puts it away for the out. And now we check out the Mariners lineup. We could be in for a power showcase today with the wind blowing out a lot of lift and separate, Chris.
Well, we know guys are in this era definitely trying to hit the ball in the air regardless of the conditions, but I think even a little more so there's margin for error if you can get the ball up in the air. So, you know, you'll see at times, I'm sure, with two strikes, what looks like a half swing that can get out of the ballpark with a guy who's got decent pop.
That misses, 2-1. One out, base is empty. Misses just off the outside edge. I think that was a strike.
Evidently not too impressed with that call, and it feels like he got squeezed on the outside corner, so he's making his case. You've got to be careful to pick your spots in terms of showing your frustration with the umpire, and he felt this was his time.
To the right side, Castro throws the first in time.
Batting third, the center fielder, Julio Rodriguez.
Two outs, base is empty. And now it's Julio Rodriguez. Two outs, base is empty. Big swing and a miss.
Well, he looks to have some quality stuff on the hill today. Start this outing out. Pepper in the zone. Arm is loose and firing him in there.
And another ball. That one inside. And now 3-2.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
Foul ball left side. He'll see another. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Santana racing over to make the catch. And 1-2-3, go to Mariners. We played an inning, no score. Back in Seattle, now batting Max Kepler.
Right here, Max Kepler.
The 1-1. That catches the corner.
Wow, just a beautiful backdoor slider right there. If you got any chance of hitting that pitch, you have to wait until the absolutely last second. Just a tough pitch to hit, and not an easy one to throw either.
That was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger. Here's Carlos Correa. Late with the swing there.
One ball, two strikes.
Here's a 1-2. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. One down, base is empty. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. Off to a strong start, Singy, as he's punched out three of the first five he's faced.
Well, he's definitely minimizing contact. He can get the swing and miss when he needs it, but he'll also keep the defense fresh behind him, allowing some balls in play as well.
Two outs. Popped up under this one. Brings it in for the third out. Nothing doing here for the Twins. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. And welcome back to the ballpark. Bottom of the second. And now it's the cleanup hitter for the Mariners, Cal Raleigh. This is a guy who is very highly regarded defensively. Fun to watch him control stuff behind the plate. Good game caller. Good at framing, but it's that big arm that really stands out. The pitch.
You come into the game knowing that unless the ball's in the dirt or gets by him, we're probably not going to steal anything today. So that's where you want to get a little more aggressive on your secondary lead and hope that some base hits, some slugs, some home runs can come into play. Well, that event seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there, at least to foul something off, extend that at bat.
Ty France up next for the Mariners. And down 2-1 after that missed inside.
Well, I'll say this as a former position player and base stealer. When you come into a game and you've got a guy like this behind the dish with a big arm, you really have to change your approach. Can't try to steal because you'll get thrown out. Maybe get a little bigger lead, be aggressive on the secondary. But
oh, and a great stop. The throw, it's there, and that's a great play.
Third baseman have to be so quick with their first step reactions. Hot shots like that. That's why they call it the hot corner. That's a perfect example, though. There's no way he gloves that one if he's not dialed in, anticipating something coming his way, staying on his toes every pitch. Really nice job to get back up, set himself, and make a strong throw across the diamond.
Hard hit, right side. And the Mariners set down 1-2-3. Nothing doing here this half. We head on now to the top of the third. We're tied, nothing-nothing. And we're back on to the third inning. And now for the Twins, Byron Buxton.
Byron Buxton.
The pitch. On the inside corner for a strike. And another ball.
2-2.
A wind in the pitch. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again.
Flew open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his back down just enough to make contact with that pitch. Keep the at-bat alive. Small sigh of relief right there. I mean, just to keep that speed off the base paths, it's not just the pitcher, it's other guys that have to think about it. From your infielders, have to think about that runner potentially stealing, but also be in position to make a play. As an outfielder, you're thinking about a base hit to the outfield. I got to get to it quickly to try to keep this guy from taking an extra base. So I think everyone just a little more relaxed that he didn't reach base.
The pitch. That one's in there. And that is strike two. First two batters retired here in the top of the third.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
Two down, nobody on. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. The pitch. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And it's a three-up, three-down inning. Twins retired in short order. Still no score. Set for the bottom of the third. Now batting Mitch Haniger.
The designated hitter. Mitch Haniger.
The pitch. Just missed. And a foul ball. Righty to the plate. That one missed. Runs it up to 96 to record the punch out.
Well, definitely a borderline pitch right there, and he didn't look too convinced as he headed back to the dugout. No, those are tough ones to let go as a hitter, but with the human umpire calling balls and strikes, it's always going to be on you to protect yourself with two strikes.
And stepping in for the Mariners, Dominic Canzone. And another ball.
You won.
Still tied at zero, last of the third. Next pitch is downstairs.
3-1.
Fastball for a strike.
And boy, that was the pitch. 3-1. You want to be really aggressive on the fastball.
Payoff pitch. Stays alive. One down, base is empty. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
I love to see guys compete, and I know he's frustrated that he wasn't able to do anything with that pitch. You see it so well, but you have to respect the upper 90s velocity. Man, it is hard to catch up to.
Here's Dylan Moore. And the right-hander deals. And a good eye there. And a pitch. That one fouled off. Two outs. Lopez gets the swing and the miss. Three up, three down, inning over. Nobody left for Seattle, and we're still knotted at zero. Back in Seattle, and now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Willie Castro. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Makes a nice running catch.
And there's one away. Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
And a 1-1. That's a bullet, but it goes foul. All tied up. Top half of inning number four. One down, base is empty. Not even close there. Ball two. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Quite the start to this game on the mound. Looking very dangerous to these hitters. Seven punchouts already. So this lineup hasn't had much success. Trying to figure him out. I'm impressed with what we're seeing here.
And next for Minnesota, Royce Lewis. Swing and a miss. And it's 1-2.
One ball, two strikes.
And that misses off the outside edge.
It's a good take.
Fourth inning underway, no score. And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. Rodriguez ranging back towards the wall. Grabs it right up against the wall. So 12 up, 12 down to begin the ball game. No score. Four, and now the shortstop, J.P. Crawford.
Not shortstop.
Here's something cool, Blue. When they finished building T-Mobile Park back in 1999, they actually opened it up in the middle of the season. I remember as a rookie with the Chicago White Sox, we opened the season at the Kingdom, and then when we came back later in the year, we were playing at T-Mobile Park. It's a beautiful place, great scenery from center field, and I always enjoyed playing here.
Here's Josh Rojas. The 1-1. And a swing and a miss.
1-2.
Base is empty, one away. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. Lopez gets the swing and the miss. And two away now.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Julio.
Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder Julio Rodriguez. And a swing and a miss.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Two down, nobody on. Lifted in the air down the left side, and it's foul. One, two now. In the air, foul off first. Santana drifts towards it and makes the grab. And that is the third out of the inning. Mariners go down quietly there, and we are still scoreless. Ready now for the fifth inning. Max Kepler at the plate. Kicks and deals. That's ripped to right down the line. And that's just foul. Right-hander kicks, deals. Now Correa up to hit. And there's ball four. Now the runner on at first with one gone. And now it's the switch hitter, Carlos Santana. The Twins hitless so far in the game. Right through there for a strike. Good job to fight that one off. And he deals. Swing and a miss. Got him to go up the ladder for the K. Here's Byron Buxton. Two gone, but the go-ahead run is at first. And we're at the top of the fifth. This one in the air. Moore settles under it and makes the catch. And that'll do it. One left for Minnesota. Halfway through this one, still no score. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's the power hitting catcher, Cal Raleigh. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two. Just off the outside part of the plate.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
3-2 on the way. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to play off some really close pitches, and somehow he found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
And the righty deals. Pitch misses. Now two balls and a strike.
Put a layoff that pitch down.
Swing and a miss.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
And just misses with that one. Luke Raley up next for the Mariners. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. That one is absolutely belted. And now they're out front. It's 2-0. The shines.
Yeah, this guy lives for big moments, and right there made a statement big time.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Now here is Luke Raley, the one to kick the pitch. And that drops in for a strike.
Can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
1-2 now. Goes down looking. Now it's the Mariners DH, Mitch Haniger.
Mitch Haniger.
One down, base is empty. That's inside. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Lewis drifts towards it. Hauls it in, two away.
The left fielder, number eight, Dominic Canzone.
So up next, Dominic Canzone. Base is empty, two away, but two runs are in. Last half of inning number five. Pitch misses there, and it's 2-1.
2-1.
And another ball.
Three balls, one strike.
That's ripped. Base hit. So a two-out knock keeps the inning alive.
Well, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard like he did right there.
And now here is Dylan Moore. The 1-1 is fouled off. Laboring here, about to throw his 30th pitch of the inning. First, Canzone back on a dive. And a pitch. Runner takes off. Pitch misses in. Safe at second with a stolen base. Two outs. Battling here as he fouls it away.
Now he's desperately looking for that swing and miss. He's going to have to just change speeds a little bit, try to move it around, create just a little bit of illusion at the end.
Popped up left side. Catcher tosses the mask, settles under it. That is the inning. Two come in on this Seattle homer. And it's 2-0. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. Ryan Jeffers at the plate. Kicks and fires.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Now a fly ball to right center. Raley makes the play, and there's one away. Austin Martin, the next twin up to hit. The 1-1.
ball.
Wouldn't chase that time.
Oh, they have had a hard time scoring in this one. The pitcher out there on the mound wants to keep attacking, make sure that they don't get any confidence.
And he walked him.
First base.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
So the lineup flips over. This is Willie Castro. Roll to short, could be two. Off balance beat, there's one. Over to first, safe.
Tough play right there. Didn't really have enough time to set his feet and make a strong, accurate throw. Had to rush it, but he got it off, and he got it there in time to get that out at second base.
Here's Trevor Larnach. Miller picks over. Castro back easily. With the tying run at the plate, and we're at the top half of the sixth. Misses.
No.
Two balls, two strikes.
Oh, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity. Try to get a rollover, something on the ground. Stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
2-2 now. Bounce that off to the left, and we'll do it again. Here comes a pitch. Runner takes off. Ball outside. Safe at second, and he easily steals the bag.
Really nice swipe of second right there. He knew he had to get a really good jump on the pitcher because that catcher can make up some time. Man, such a good catch and throw guy behind the dish. Nice job right there, but he just beat it.
In danger of losing the no-hitter here. Rips that one to right. Ray makes the catch, and that'll do it. So he's through six no-hit innings now. It's the Mariners 2 and the Twins nothing. Back now for the bottom of the sixth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Steven Okert.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Steven Okert.
Next to hit, J.P. Crawford.
The Mariners, the shortstop, J.P. Crawford.
This one blasted the other way, down the line, and it's a foul ball. Swings and misses, it's a strikeout. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
I'm not sure that was the exact location the pitcher wanted, but it worked. He got the swing and miss, and I'm sure a bit of sigh of relief after seeing that one go through the zone.
Come on, Seattle.
One down, base is empty. That one fouled off, 2-2. Left-hand hitter waits. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. And another ball.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Base is empty, one away here in the bottom of the sixth. And that one is lifted in the air. Buxton moves under it. Hauls it in, and there's two away.
the center fielder, number 44, Julio.
Two outs, bases empty. And now for Seattle, Julio Rodriguez. And a pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Fights it off. You'll see another. And here it comes. Got him swinging. Mariners are down in order. They're up 2-0. Top of inning number 7. And now for the Twins, Royce Lewis.
Notice how they're swinging too early or too late? That's a timing problem. They need to guess right on a few of those pitches. And I mean make an educated guess.
Falling behind 2-1.
We get to this part of the order. Yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will.
That's a strike, and it's 3-2.
They hope he's the guy to spark a comeback. He tends to play better when his team is behind, so why not him?
Swing and a miss. Slider got him for strike 3. The big first out here in the 7th via the punch out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you got the leadoff hitter, so critical in setting the table when you got a tight game like this. So a strikeout really puts them on their heels.
Max Kepler, the next twin up to him. And that's through there for a strike.
You know, he's been so great today. Really just throwing whatever the catcher puts down. I mean, hasn't shaken off the catcher very much at all today.
That one inside. Counts full, 3-2. Foul ball, he stays alive. The wind of the pitch. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball 4.
Well, he's starting to look a little gassed to me, and we'll see if they go to the bullpen in this spot or not.
And here comes Carlos Correa. The Twins still looking for their first hit in this one. And that one fouled off. The tying run at the plate. Gets a piece and stays alive. That one way outside, and it's 2-2. In the air, center field. Rodriguez settles under it, pulls it down, and he makes the catch. And there's 2 away. Next, to switch hitting first baseman, Carlos Santana. Tying run at the plate. That one blasted deep to right. That's back. And that one is out of here. It breaks up the no-no with a homer. And we're all square. It's 2-2.
That's a game changer right there. A big time swing, and we're all tied up. Well, he almost robbed the home run right there. And I tell you what, he'd love another crack at it. During batting practice, you always like to work on that. And so close, but that one was just out of his reach.
So it's all tied up thanks to the home run. And now, Byron Buckley. Now, this ball is well hit. This one's got a chance. Pulls it in on the warning track. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. 2-2 game. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Jay Jackson.
Now pitching for Minnesota, number 32, Jay Jackson.
Now it's going to be Cal Raleigh.
He's a big, strong guy. Can untie this game with one swing.
Here's a 1-1. Way out front for strike two. Some movement in the Twins' bullpen. Caleb Thielbar getting loose out there. Alcala, the right-hander, loosening up as well. The pitch. And a swing and a miss. One away. Big time out leading off the home seven. So digging in, Ty France. Two-two. Slider misses outside. Ripped on a line. Makes the grab, and there's two gone.
Good piece of hitting right there. Nice hard line drive to the outfield. You're trying to get on base, represent that go-ahead run. Can't hang your head on that at all.
And up next for Seattle, Luke Rayleigh. Two down, nobody on. Here the bottom of the seventh. And a swing and a miss there.
He has a tendency to chase out of the zone, and that slider that's down, that's one of his money pitches to get that swing and miss.
And now 2-2.
That's a really good take right there. Slider down and in. Very difficult to get on the same plane and do anything with.
Two down, nobody on. And right through the right, and that's a base hit.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. That pitch was in and off the plate. So hard to do anything with the pitch in that location, but somehow he got the barrel to it and hit it well. Pretty amazing. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Runner at first with two away. And next is the designated hitter, Mitch Haniger. And he can't make the play. And he's going to make it to first, and we'll see how they score it. So two on with two away. And stepping in for the Mariners, Dominic Canzone. And another ball. And that's ball four.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boog. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
Two outs, bases full. Dylan Moore, the next to hit. Rayleigh at third. Haniger over at second. Canzone on at first with two down.
And that's a little bit high. This point of the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. And that is the inning. And the Mariners strand the bases loaded. Score remains 2-2. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Number Trent Thornton. And now the Twins catcher, Ryan Jeffers.
The catcher, Ryan Jeffers.
Fouled off. He was late. comes the 2-2. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth. Here's the left fielder, Austin Martin. The pitch. And that is in for a strike. It's 2-2. Action in the bullpen for Seattle. Mike Bauman appears to be getting ready for manager Scott Servais. Vogt getting loose as well. And that one is in the dirt. 3-2 now. Willie Castro in the on-deck circle for the Twins. One down, base is empty. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. At the belt and fires. He fouls it off. We'll do it again. Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk. It wasn't easy, but he earned that walk after a long at bat.
Well, that's a really dangerous base runner to put on first, especially in a tie game. Now there might be some consequences coming from that mistake.
Good eye right there.
If you're a base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get in the scoring position.
Late that time, it's strike two.
Man, he was really tardy on that fastball. Great job of setting him up by throwing the curveball. Add some velocity to it on the next pitch. Can't catch up.
Way inside, gets out of the way. Reaches over the wall, and he's got it!
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Now at the plate, Trevor Larnach. The kick and the pitch. Runner goes. That's in for a strike. Throw to second. Great jump. And that is a stolen base. It wasn't even close.
Well, it really doesn't matter what the situation is. When a guy like this gets on first, you know he's going to steal second at some point during the at-bat. Nice job to get in the scoring position. The defense probably knew it was coming, but they just couldn't do anything to stop it.
Two down, go ahead, run in scoring position.
He's in a tough spot, had to make a great pitch, did it, got the strikeout, gets out of the jam. Clearly, he's happy with those results.
Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Caleb Fieldmore.
Bringing in the lefty with the left-handed hitter coming up to hit. Classic bullpen move right here, so we'll see how it works out.
Back to the top of the Seattle order. Here's the Mariners' leadoff man, J.P. Crawford.
J.P. Crawford.
1-1 now. And that's in for a strike. And a pitch. Fights that one away, still 1-2. Swing and a ground ball off the middle. That's a base hit. A leadoff single, and the go-ahead run is aboard.
Always feels amazing getting a job done when the team needs you to play. It's just bigger than your own individual stats.
Just kept it simple. Played Pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
Making a move at first, and here's the pinch runner, Ryan Bliss. No outs, runner at first. And now for Seattle, Josh Rojas. And another ball.
Two balls, one strike.
Pitch. Runner on the go. And that one fouled off. With the go-ahead run at first, here in the bottom half of the eighth inning. Swing and a fly ball in the air out towards right center field. And that'll fall for a base hit. And now runners at the corners, nobody out.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
Digging in, Julio Rodriguez. And it is 2-1.
In the infield at the corners, don't be surprised to see them come home first and prevent that run from scoring.
Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third. That one misses, and the count is 3-1. Cal Raleigh on deck for the M's. That one's in there, and the count's full.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Got him! Huge strikeout there. So he needed a strikeout there, and he got it. And now we'll see how they play it defensively.
Yeah, now they can move the middle infielders back a little bit, get into double play depth, and look for a ground ball and roll it up, get a big double play, get out of this inning. I tell you what, that was a big strikeout in a spot where they really needed one.
Bliss, the runner at third. Rojas at first, one gone. And a swing and a miss. The hat trick. Now two out.
Oh, tough night at the dish. Punching out for the third time right there. Just hasn't looked very comfortable at the plate. A little unsure of his timing right now. Not picking up the spin and location of these pitches. He'll have some adjustments to make.
At the plate, Ty France. Two on, two outs. Pitch is in there, and the count is 1-2. Two outs. Now this is a rocket to left. Squeezes it, and that will end the inning. Mariners leave a couple. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. Now into the ball game on defense, Ryan Bliss. He's in at shortstop. So out of the bullpen for the Mariners, Austin Gold.
Number 30, Austin.
Now the third baseman, Royce Lewis.
The third baseman,
Royce Lewis.
Right-handed reliever. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. The wind of the pitch. Wouldn't chase that time. Max Kepler, next to bat for Minnesota. The pitch. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Strikeout for the first out here in the ninth.
He's locked in at the plate, but he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to let the ball travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
So now it's the four-hole hitter, Max Kepler. And that's off the inside edge. And a count 2-1. All tied up here at the top of the ninth. On the ground right side. And it's just foul. That was close. This to third. Fires across the diamond. And that quickly, two away.
Well, there's a lot riding on that at bat right there. Nice job of the pitcher to bear down, make the pitch, get the ground ball. Excellent piece of work.
Carlos Correa, the next twin up to hit. The 1-2.
Ball.
Stays alive. Two down, nobody on. In the air, out to center, and that'll fall for a base hit.
Pitch was on the outside, didn't go the other way with it, but still a nice job of using the big part of the field to find a hole. No way he hits it that well if he hooks around the baseball though.
Looks like we've got a substitution at first. Entering is the pinch runner, Manuel Margot. Two outs, runner at first. Carlos Santana now at the plate. And there's a strike to the outside corner. It's 2-2. Two outs. That misses the zone. 3-2 now.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Byron Buxton in the on-deck circle. Throw to first. It's low and gets away. Two gone. The possible go-ahead run at first. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Canzone has a beat on it, and that's the third out. One hit, one left. 6-7-8 scheduled to start the bottom of the ninth. We are tied 2-2. Back now as they hand the ball to a fresh arm to start the bottom of the ninth. Jorge Alcala. Now,
number 66.
Now into the game, Kyle Farmer. He's in at shortstop.
Number 12, Kyle.
And now, Luke Raley.
The right fielder, Luke Raley.
And another ball. Minnesota's bullpen with some action. Yoan Duran warming up for manager Rocco Baldelli. That one misses. Now 3-1.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
To the right side. Tosses to first, and they get the leadoff man in the ninth.
That play won't be trending on social media later on, but it's still important to execute it to perfection. This game is a lot harder than it looks, Parker.
In now is the Mariners DH, Mitch Haniger. Righty delivers. And that's a strike.
It's amazing to look up and see 88 miles per hour on that changeup. Back in the day, that was a pretty good fastball. But with high velocities these days, that speed differential is right where it needs to be.
Got him swinging for the K. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three.
Well, that high forcing fastball has become such a great pitch for pitchers to finish hitters off. They're trying to stay back with two strikes, make sure that they can handle something off speed, and just with good spin rate, good rotation through the zone, elevate it a little bit, get a lot of swings and misses, and that's a really nice job right there.
That's the third out, and we're headed to extras. And 1-2-3 go the Mariners. And this game is still tied at 2-2. Back now, and we're in extras. A new arm on the mound here in the top half of the inning, Mike Baumann. And he'll feature a hard slider to work off his fastball. Here's the center fielder, Byron Buxton. Man at second, nobody out. Chris, certainly one of the things in his head is trying to get the runner over.
Yeah, the way that we see the game played today, though, guys are not sacrificing as much just to get that runner across. They're really looking at doing damage. Slugging is the name of the game.
Well, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a ball or anything. I just think he was flat out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
Now, here is Ryan Jeffers. Man at second. And a count 1-2. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. One out. The go-ahead run is at second. Here are the top half of the 10th. Wouldn't chase that time.
Full count.
Austin Martin to bat next. And here's a 3-2. Swings. And that's a strikeout.
Nice work there to get the strikeout, and that's a big second out. I'll tell you, this home crowd will be fired up. They can get out of this and leave that go-ahead run stranded in scoring position. This is a big moment in this game.
Now the left fielder, Austin Martin. Swung on, belted. Rodriguez on the move, racing back. Pulls it in on the warning track. And welcome back to the ballpark. Here's the second baseman, Dylan Moore. Pitch. Laser. Base hit. Headed for the plate. In comes the winning run and the
you know, he had to feel the pressure. Winning run on second base. Found a way to make solid contact, and the winning run comes across to score. Everyone going crazy. Exciting finish to this game today.
The final score, a one-run extra inning win for Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew. I'm John Ciambi saying so long from T-Mobile Park in Seattle.
First for the victorious Seattle Mariners. Three runs on seven hits. No errors. They left six runners on base.